Guys, can you hear me?
Yeah, buddy. Loud and clear.
You have to unmute to speak, my friend.
Guys, Raman is here. Hey, Ram.
Hey, guys.
Hello, people.
Hey, Ahmed.
Tanisha, is your mic all right?
Gosh, seriously, Tanisha. You have to unmute. You're still on mute.
Can you hear me now? It's an honest mistake.
Behold, the MD of Amul Cooperatives does not know how to unmute her mic. I am not going to recommend or use Amul products anymore.
Cut us some slack, dude.
Bro, Ahmed, are you alright?
Yeah, I'm just glad.
No, man, you aren't.
Yeah, what's wrong? It's
clear. I'm just fine.
What's wrong?
No, something's wrong.
Okay, the living conditions here are catastrophic. It's total madness.
What? What are you saying? Kashmir is like the heaven on earth.
Yeah, you can't deny that. I mean, look at the place. So beautiful, so chilly, literal paradise of places. Indeed. Can't say otherwise. There's enough potential here to mint money too. But ask yourself this. Why is no investor, no entrepreneur, no skilled laborer setting foot on JNK? Lived here all my life and still can't get over the fact how beautiful this place is. Probably that's what blinded us from seeing how ugly the people were getting.
But what exactly happened?
You all know the sensitivity of this state, right? The people, they are just as innocent and confused as they look. The government is afraid to provide them any needed support after the first few rounds of subsidies failed. Because the locals don't support the government. Like, they are being brainwashed by the terrorists and the militias to support them instead of the government. Like, they give them money, facilities, and all of that. It's like throwing bones to a dog, but those bones were pulled out from the dog's ribs itself. With that being done, the terrorists, they threw peanuts to the locals and are minting billions on our back. It's dirty international politics going on, which is really dangerous to even say on record. If the people's ignorance is not cleared off fast enough, there's a high possibility that India may become the next Buchenwald.
Why didn't you tell this at the first?
I did not want you guys to feel bad, you know, with this whole pandemic going on. The atmosphere around everybody is already depressing.
But bro, if there is any problem, we gotta face it. And we are not gonna live unpleasantly with it.
Yeah, life is too short to spend in an unpleasant atmosphere. We tried many things, but JNK is a universe on its own. There are things that are too absurd for outside world to know, but being a local, we do. People are innocent, man. They're just confused. And as I said, these bad guys, they brainwash the people from trusting our own government. Failing that, you know, the major oppression and non-cooperation, the government is holding back all the investments for JNK's welfare.
Do you have a plan of action, Ahmed?
As a matter of fact, I do. First, we need to get the people's support. Once that's done, the majority of work, consider it done. To get that, one has to step into the field, gather up all the SHGs in the area, then provide them job training, market linkages, sustainable development programs. If we are able to achieve all of that, then the people will gain self-confidence, you know, because they have started earning their own income. And then, I can take care of the groundwork because the NGO I run and me being a local, that will grant me access. But still, we need government support, job trainers, skill labelers, and funds, a lot of funds to lend out microcredit.
I mean, look at us. Each one of us have our own distinct ways in which we can contribute towards this. And provided all of us work together, we can totally overcome this. I mean, from my side, I can provide whatever is needed as part of the white revolution.
Yeah, with skilled workers, it'll make it a bit trouble-free for the government to carry out the mission. I, being the secretary at the O Ministry, can totally help out with the government support aspects.
If you're positive on that, Ram, then we, Nitin, who was unfortunately wasn't able to make it to the call today, and I will be able to help out with the development of tourism and market linkage aspects.
Karan, just because the secretary of the Home Ministry and the directors of these particular departments agreed to help, how do you think the central would approve dispatching funds to a private NGO?
As a funds, you don't need to worry about that. I got promoted recently only as the South Asia head, and I can recommend the World Bank, you know, to dispatch the required fund after calculation by all of us. And then, Ahmed, you can dispose them, you know, as microcredits to the self-help groups to whom you have provided job training.
Well, that sounds like a solid plan. Honestly, I think we should give it a shot.
Hey, Tanisha.
Dummy.
Finally, yes.
Sorry for the last call, I wasn't there. But I caught up with Ahmed. So, what's up?
Everyone, to begin with, I extend extreme thanks for the contribution from every single one of you.
Oh gosh, don't be so formal.
So, what's the status, Ahmed?
Well, we have been seeing our graphs go bullish, like a couple days after the first video call, thanks to Roshan, because the funds came in from World Bank, and I and some of my staff, we headed over to a few villages near Srinagar, and then we had a meeting with the folks there. First, they were not too interested. They were in this, I want to go kind of attitude. And then slowly we explained to them about the job training and the whole microcredit scheme. And we got the women to pile up into SHGs. The men, however, were taken care of in the next meeting.
Sounds smooth. When do you have the next meeting?
About 3 days later, we headed over to the state HQ of Amul and got to talk with the manager there and went over to the village with a couple of officers. Thanks to Tanisha's recommendation, they explained to the men in the village about how cattle farming can be done, you know, as collectively and also as individually, and how the cooperative can provide them good money for every drop of milk they turn in.
Any problems in the course of action?
Nothing major apart from the villagers initially being against the project. And thanks to Raman's support, those government officials he sent in, those guys really knew how to handle political pressures.
I mean, the people's mentality of being against the idea was purely due to the fear and ignorance.
So, how have the people been doing now?
They have never been better, actually. Like, now, about 10 SHGs per village, and we have covered 90% of the villages so far. All the SHG leaders have this clear understanding as to which SHG produces what. Like, if one SHG produces candle, no other SHG in the area produces candle. This understanding is one of our greatest things. They are also given proper job trainings, and it was about a month and a half back, and now they got their market linkages done. So their business is seeing pretty great profits, and guess what? There was not even a single loan default from any of them. Both the SHGs and the cattle farmers, they repaid their loan in time perfectly.
Oh, that's great.
What next?
Now that we have the people's support and their welfare is taken care of, we need to focus on the state's welfare. Yes, guys, this isn't over just with the people's welfare. they are not fully safe now. They are still vulnerable to be brainwashed by, you know, who? Evil forces.
I second that. You know, out of the Sustainable Livelihood Initiative, we have done a livelihood initiative, just that, you know, we know you need to go more sustainable.
Yes, it makes sense.
Yeah. So to do that, Nitin and Karan, now would be the right time for you guys to step in. Do you have any proposals?
Yeah. So locals who live in the lakes will all have boats, and people who already have boats can and make a community to rent boats to tourists so that they can charge them per time and make a lot of money. And once J&K becomes a well-known tourist spot, then the state's per capita income will increase really high. And the evil forces, as you mentioned, won't stand a chance to brainwash them once they have an amount of money.
You know, the floriculture department can step in and improve the apple orchards where the tourists can have little pick your own basket orchid. And also the locals in the ideal locations, you know, they can be taught to grow these willow trees so that they can engage in the production of cricket bats. And also, you know, flower gardens can be improved, and we can create a nature park for the tourists to come and spend their time.
Just a second, guys. Like, hear me out. Like, why don't we get some help from the forest department, you know, and establish a wildlife safari? Like, the people can see the brown bears and then the Himalayan tar and then the ibex, a lot of such animals.
Yeah, I think I can make that happen because I have a few contacts in the wildlife department so that, yeah, it can be worked out.
Guys, like, doesn't it feel like we, like, what we're doing right now seems very familiar? Like, I have a feeling that we've studied, like, certain chapters of what we're doing right now.
Yes, Ganesha, you're right. Like, we learned accounts in 11th and 12th, where we learned bookkeeping and final accounts in class 11th, whereas we learned financial statement and ratio analysis in class 12th, where the concepts which we learned thereby 15 years before, we can just correlate with the things which we are doing now, like the growth concept, the equity of opportunity to access markets, resources on unbiased regulatory environment for businesses and individuals by empowering them with knowledge of accounting and financial management in order to remain viable to income generating enterprises on a sustainable basis.
Yeah, yeah. Which page number was it again?
Gosh, we didn't even change a little bit, man. You're the same, Raman. Oh, I saw back in that school. My goodness.
None of us have changed, brother. Back then, if one of us had a problem, all of us pitched in some help. Look at us now. Same since 2005.
We did it, guys. We made our dream become reality.
Sure we did. Look at J&K's per capita now.
From 65,000 to 2 lakhs.
I mean, aside from the monetary value, just look at the people. They are genuinely happy and peaceful with no more threats of terrorism or poverty. They aren't living a life filled with fear.
For sure, there's no more BOK. It all belongs to India. But how? How did 6 individuals carry out something that even one of the world's most powerful governments couldn't carry out?
We can't blame anyone. Whatever their perspective was, wasn't the same as ours. They saw a state, we saw the people. And more so, it wasn't 6 individuals, Anisha. It was one team. One amazing team which brought about the change. Like they say, V is greater than I. We did it, guys. Finally.